Riots and civil disturbances are on the increase everywhere. Press reports from around the world show that many such demonstrations, whether peaceably intended or not, have developed into riots, with resulting police casualties, loss of life, and property. It can happen here, wherever you are. It's a police problem. Once such a civil disturbance has broken out, there are tactics based on planned employment of necessary minimum force that can be used to bring it under control. What you are about to see are the most basic, important, and effective techniques. An assembly area near the disturbance, but out of sight of the rioters, should be designated. The individual officers and their vehicles should be directed to this area, which can also serve as a communication command post. When the riot unit has formed, it is ready for that first important psychological move, the show of force. The surprise appearance of a specially equipped, disciplined police unit early in the action will often be sufficient to dominate the situation. The first official act will usually be the order to disperse. It is best amplified with a bullhorn system.
This is Lieutenant Childers, a police officer of this city. I hereby declare this to be an unlawful assembly. I command you to disperse or be subject to arrest.
If the mob refuses to comply, there are a number of possible courses to follow. The wedge-type formation is used for breaking a mob into segments. It is also used to enter a mob to rescue a wounded officer or seize an agitator or ringleader. When an agitator is taken, it is imperative that he be removed from the scene immediately. Without their leader, the mob will be confused and more easily broken up. The line is a formation useful in denying an objective to a crowd. For example, blocking an entrance or gate. It can also be used in clearing a mob from an area. The diagonal is used in turning a crowd away from a wall or fence, or diverting a moving crowd in a different direction. The weapons used at controlling the mob are varied. Today, mobs are of both sexes and all ages. Against such groups, an effective weapon is the long baton. Men trained in its correct use will face the mob with confidence. Its full length is used in offense and defense, and in restraining or handling crowds. The tip and butt end of the riot baton can be used to deliver thrusts, jabs, and smashes. The prime objective in any disturbance is to confuse and break up the mob. In the first critical stage, one of the most effective weapons is obscuring smoke. It can be released by a grenade or by a handheld projector. White obscuring smoke does not stain or contaminate. It is non-toxic and, like tear gas, must be used with favorable wind. An escape route must be left open to the mob. Obscuring smoke confuses and demoralizes. What once was a cohesive group with a unified purpose becomes a collection of panic-stricken individuals. Smoke is also highly effective in dispersing the passive lie-down, sit-down demonstrators, eliminating the need of carrying them away. Phases of riots can best be countered by the use of tear gas.
Come
Police should try to employ tear gas upwind of the mob, if possible. Grenade that separates into three sections is effective against loosely dispersed rioters. In a no-wind condition, it is often advisable to use an instantaneous blast-type grenade. When in close contact with the mob, use the short-range blast shell. Remember, present a disciplined, united, uniformed front. A show of force is sometimes all that is necessary. Employ only men who have been drilled in the tactical formations. You can usually rely on the progressive employment of your riot formations, the baton, smoke, and tear gas to break up most civil disturbances. Use firearms only as a last resort. Break up the crowd. Keep it moving. When the mob's dispersed, keep it that way, and the riot is over.